So my name is Zach Romack, and my group and I did an analysis on the University of Pittsburgh student mailroom, in particular the Tower B location. The Tower B student mailroom services all of the quad buildings as well as Center Plaza and Forbes Craig Apartments, which means it services roughly 3,500 students, making it the largest mailroom on the University of Pittsburgh. So to start with the process that the mailroom operates under, different carriers bring packages at different times of the day, and when they deliver them in the orange hods shown here. The packages will not be sorted in any way, and the assortment inside the hods will be completely random based off of color and size. So the first thing that the workers typically do is take them and organize them in these white bins according to color and size of the package. Once they're arranged and ready, they then wait in this area until a worker is ready to process them. So going into processing the packages, they will then be taken to one of these two write-up stations as shown here. And the different colors will be written up together, so all the yellows will be written up at the same time, all the whites will be written up at the same time, and this is the computer system used here. As you can see, the student will look up the name in terms of the first letter of the last name of the student who received the package. They'll verify the room number, they'll write a description stating where the package is going to be put and what it looks like, and then they'll print a label at one of these two stations. However, it's important to note that these two stations serve different functions. The one closest to the door here writes up packages at all times, and that's all it does, whereas this station here is used either as a dispersion station or as a write-up station. Typically, at the beginning of the year, when packages are getting brought in more frequently due to textbooks and everybody coming back to school, they'll both be writing up packages at all times because there'll be more to process. But in later parts of the year, this desk right here will be the only one that processes. So finally, after they're written up and a University of Pittsburgh label is put on the packages, the students will then shelve them in alphabetical order. The shelves starting here will start with A's, and they'll go all the way to the back, all the way to Z. The letter on the shelf is again based off of the first letter of the student's last name. And it's important to note that the different shelves contribute to different sizes of the packages. So these silver shelves right here will be your small to medium sized packages, typically envelopes or small boxes. There'll be an above section, which is up here on top of the mailbox cubbies. Those will be medium sized packages, even large ones that aren't very heavy. And then there's a floor section for the boxes that can't be lifted very high or that are just too big to go on this section up here. So finally, dispersion to the students. When the students come, they give their ID to whatever worker is at the window, as shown right here. The worker searches for the package based off the student's last name. They find the information and where it is, tell another worker, and that second worker goes to retrieve the package. While they're doing so, the student will use the signing pad right there to sign their name and verify that they picked up the package that was scanned out to them. And when the worker comes, they have to inspect the package and make sure that the room number on the package is the same as the room number that the student tells them. And as long as all those match up, the student will get their package and be on them.
So the goal of the mailroom is to get packages in and out as efficiently as possible. The mailroom does not generate any profits, therefore it's not necessary to cut workers, but to optimize their time. So there are four main problems that we observed in the mailroom. First, the layout does not promote the motion throughout the mailroom. The desk orientation does not facilitate optimal student service time, as workers are not faced towards the service window, and it does not allow easy access in and out of the desk area. Second, shelves are often very far and require a substantial walking distance for workers. Third, the write-up desk is very crowded. All the objects the staff used are condensed into one corner, and it's often hard to maneuver around the desk. And finally, the iHUD, which is under the desk. So when students arrive and a package is in the iHUD, the workers must bend down and stay bent until they find the package.
We created ThermBlade to help determine the cycle time of scanning in packages for labeling. A flow process chart was created to show the steps in distributing mail to students at the window in Towers Mailroom.
This is a video of Zach Romack distributing mail to a student in the Towers Mailroom.
Remember? Another flow process chart was made to show the steps in labeling incoming mail and then scanning it into the system.
This is a video of Zach Remack, an employee of Towers Mailroom, labeling packages.
Established the constraint of the semicircular shape of the mailroom, but we were able to change the internal layout. So these orange rectangles here represent the hods that would be next to the desks. This gray square right here represents a shelf for the existing iHUD, which would be under this desk. And then we had moved the supervisor's desk from this corner here to right next to the manager's cubicle to increase walking space for the employees. The packages will still come in through the same door and then be sorted by color, and then they'll be placed in the hods on either side of the workers at the desk shown in the previous slide. And the worker will grab the package from the hod, move it to the center of them, scan it and index it into the system, put a label on it, and then put it in the mail sorting cart on the left or the right of them, depending on which side they are. And then at this point, any point, the employees can come in and take that cart so that there won't be any wasted time or walking distance carrying armfuls of packages to and from the shelves. Here's a figure of our new proposed shelving layout. So as you can see, we have the packages being in order of arrival rather than alphabetically. So for example, A1 through A5 would be the first shelving unit of the first packages that come in. And then there'd be the technically supposed to be the first ones that go out of the system. And this way that this limits the employees walking to and from the far distances to Z, for example. And also it can free up further shelves for student belongings that currently have no place to go.
Another change that we are proposing is the optimization of the iHUD. So currently the iHUDs are placed under the main computer where you check in, and the worker has to bend down and search through an unsorted bin to find your package. So what we are suggesting is having a shelf that is behind the computer, so you reach back and it's already alphabetized, so all you can do is just get the name and you will find the package in there. This saves time. It's more. So the workstation at the Towers Mailroom does not implement 5S. 5S is a five-step organization technique that creates and maintains an intuitive workspace. So the S's stand for sort, set in order, shine, standardize, and sustain. And these just keep the components organized and eliminates waste and optimizes efficiency. So we propose that the computers, the telephone, the scanner, the label machine, and the mouse all be outlined so you know that where they go and where they belong, and if they are not in that place, that you know that they are in the wrong location. We observe that in the afternoon there are four workers and only two or three of them are actually doing work. There is always one worker that is sitting there at the station being idle. Since the mailroom does not generate any profits because the student workers there usually are there for a work study assignment, cutting workers is not necessary. However, redistributing the workers so that there are more in the morning shifts where they can index the incoming packages for the day is the most efficient. We also, this will also create less worker idle time for the workers that are sitting there and allow other workers to actually have a job to do.